Hi, I'm Kathy Dial, and I manage our consumer response team here at Frito-Lay. We hear from about 400,000 of our fans every year, consumers who have questions or comments about our products. Our goal is to respond to their questions and concerns so that we can use that information to help make our brands as well as the Frito-Lay experience the best it can be. Consumers have a lot of curiosity about our products. They want to know where we get the ideas for our flavors and for the products that we introduce every year. We're here today in the Culinary Innovation Center at Frito-Lay, and we're here with Chef Stephen Khalil, and we're going to get a little bit of an insider's view into that process. So hello, Chef Stephen.
Hello, Kathy. Thank you for having me here.
You bet. And tell us a little bit about your background.
Well, Kathy, I've been in the business for over 20 years, and it started off with a family business. Always in product development and food product development. But in my role here as corporate executive research chef for Frito-Lay North America, I'm tasked with bringing culinary excellence and integrating that with the excellence in food science. And we're leveraging a discipline that we call culinology. Literally, it is a blending of culinary arts and food science and technology, and it helps us create best-in-class flavors and products for our Lay's lovers.
Well, consumers want to know, or they're telling us about things that they're interested in. Mm-hmm. So how do you take that information and turn that into some of the things you're developing today?
That's a very good question. What we do is we listen closely, and we go to the essence of what the consumer is telling us by constantly interacting with the Lay's lovers, the Frito lovers, to understand what their touch points are with food and what they'd like to experience as far as flavor adventures on our products. But we also identified the fact that we're becoming diverse as an American community. Regional cuisine is becoming more and more widespread throughout the country, and there's at least 50 different types of regionality, whether it comes to cuisine, locally sourced ingredients, preferences as far as the people that live in that area. So it was a lot of research and understanding of how we could take those 50, narrow them down to the top six that are approachable to a large population.
We're getting a lot of wonderful feedback on these new flavors. Our fans really love the fact that they're lower in sodium and the seasonings are all natural. And one of the favorites is Lay's Tangy Carolina Barbecue.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about what inspired that flavor.
That flavor was inspired by a traditional Carolina barbecue pulled pork sandwich. We took the actual barbecue pulled pork product itself and held that up as a culinary gold standard reference for which we wanted our flavor design work to be to work against. It actually became the DNA of the seasoning using all natural ingredients that became the flavor system for those wonderful Lay's. And what I'd like is for you to taste a little bit of this and then taste a chip and tell us how close we got.
Great.
Are you getting that savory pork? Probably not noticing the hint of paprika, but you'd miss it if it wasn't there, and the herbs and the seasonings.
I'd say you nailed it. Those are wonderful, and it's amazing how the chips taste like the pork.
It's culinology in action. Culinary arts with the best-in-class food science and technology, all natural flavors, lower sodium product, and you have wonderful Lay's Tangy Carolina Barbecue. How about
wonderful.
That?
Wonderful. Chef, thank you so much for sharing the process with us and to give our consumers an insider view on how this all comes together. Thanks for joining us today. Hope to see you next time.